are even denied by the medical community that they exist. Chronic Lyme disease, chronic mycoplasma infections, chronic Epstein-Barr infections. They're given sort of like a side, they're sort of like a sideline in the teaching and the medical community, and are not giving their true place, because they seem to be active in almost everybody that we see. Chronic mold infection, chronic parasite infestation. Those things have been extremely rare when I graduated from medical school, and now it's our everyday discovery in our patients that are chronically ill that they have these things. And so when we look deeper, what is it that has changed in the last 15, 20 years that these chronic infections have become so prevalent? And what we discovered is very simple. It's the exposure to electromagnetic fields. The only thing that parallels the exponential increase in in chronic neurological illness, you know, with the low-grade depression, the insomnia, the muscle aches and pains, and the fatigue, and the strange neurological symptoms with tingling, numbness, vibration in the body. The only that increases exponentially. The number of children to be diagnosed autistic doubles every 5 years now. There's no more an issue, well, are we over-diagnosing it? No, it doubles every 5 years. The only thing that parallels that increase is the increased exposure to man-made electromagnetic fields, largely in the high-frequency range. There's some exceptions that have also increased, but largely it's the high-frequency range from cell phone radiation, from the Tetra network that the police and other systems are using. The smart meters are the worst invention that we've followed in the last 2 years. There's absolutely devastating consequences that I will share with you. The only development that parallels the exponential increase that we observe in neurological disease is the exponential increase in exposure to man-made electromagnetic fields. So as a scientist, we don't have to look very far, but neurological disease, Parkinson's, MS, ALS, autism, learning disabilities in children, behavioral problem in children, that's all exploding exponentially. And the only thing that fits from an environmental perspective and from an epidemiological perspective is that this is the electromagnetic waves that are penetrating our body that are responsible for this. And fortunately enough, we have good science now.
Over the past 80 years, more than 6,000 research studies have been published on the biological effects of electromagnetic radiation. The majority of these studies have shown biological damage being done. Of the many more recent advances in research, one notable study was published earlier this year by the University of Athens. The results over an 8-month period showed 143 proteins in the mammalian brain were altered after exposure to either a mobile phone or a decked phone base, including proteins which have already been linked to Alzheimer's, glioblastoma, stress, and metabolism. Lead author Adamantia Fragipolu states, "This study is anticipated to throw light in the understanding of health effects like headaches, dizziness, sleep disorders, memory disorders, brain tumors, all of them related to the function of the altered brain proteins."
This permanently destroys and alters the manufacturing of these proteins, meaning it completely changes the human organism permanently. The DNA inside the cell is a booklet, an instruction booklet, how to make proteins. And we have about 120,000 to 200,000 different proteins that are in the cell or in the cell wall, the receptors, you know, how the cell wall communicates with the outside environment is through proteins. And inside the cell, the manufacturing that each cell does of antibodies, of neuropeptides, of hormones, of cholesterol, of building blocks that the body needs to replace, used up body parts, that's all done by proteins. Even the physical structure of your body changes. We've seen a host of people that had normal body weight for 40 years or 50 years, and suddenly their weight exploded when the phone company put up the cell phone tower 200 yards from their house, not even that close, 300 yards from their house.